Hello learners, this will be my last video of exercise 4.5 and I am going to finish and I hope I will solve last three sums of question number 12 and 13 in this video. So let's start. Our first question is 32 a² x³ - 8b² x³ - 4a² y³ + b² y³. So what I was thinking, I will divide this question into two parts. From first two parts, I will take something common, and from second, anything other, which will be common factor from last two terms. So from these two terms, what I can take common, I can see 8 is there, okay, and x is also there. So 8x³ will be common. So what will be the remaining thing here? 8 4 32 and a square. X cube is already outside. And here 8x³ is outside the bracket, so here is b² only, okay. Now from second group, what I can take as common, that will be, you can see there is yq which may be taken as common factor. So what are the remaining thing? Here is 4a² - b² because minus is also as common, that's why this plus changed as minus. Now from both the groups, see, we are applying the first and second method of exercise 4.1 and 4.2, and methods were named as taking common factors or by grouping the numbers. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. If you are watching regularly my all videos, then only you can understand what I said just now. From these two terms, I can take common 4a² - b² then what is the remaining thing here? In first group, only 8x³ will left here, and in second group there is -y³. Now these two terms we have to convert as a³ - b³ because still 8 is it not in form of a³, so we will convert that. Before that, we will write this as it is. Here is minus, children, please don't be confused. Now what? Now this is 2x³ - y³. Next, 4a² - b² a³ - b³, so this will be a² + ab + b². So I'm going to do that, that is 2x - y, then 2x² + 2x (y) + y² bracket close. I will solve it a little bit. 4a² - b² we may write it like 2a² + b² okay. So this is 2a² - b² so that we can write a + b, a - b, this one also. And here 2x - y, this will be 4x² + 2xy + y². So this bracket work is done. We will solve this one. This is a² - b² formula. So a + b (a - b) will write 2a + b (2a - b). This will be 2x - y. And here is 4x² + 2xy + y². So these are the four factors of this given algebraic equation or expression. Done. Now question number 13. First question was x^9 + y^9, solve it. First of all, we'll try to convert it into cubic form. So x³ (whole cube) + y³ (whole cube). Again, I am telling you that power to the power are multiplied. That's why 3 3s are 9, 3 3s are 9. Now what? This is a³ + b³, so we will use that formula. What? a + b. So in place of a + b, we will write x³ + y³. Then in second bracket, a² - ab + b². So in place of a², I will write x³² - ab. For that, I will write x³, y³, and at last for b² I will write y³², okay. Then after this I will write, you can see here x³ + y³ is again here. First of all, copy it, means once again we can open it. this is x to the power 6, 3 into 2. I told you power to the power will be multiplied. X cube, y cube plus y to the power 6. If you will see, you can think that, okay, our answer is over. So these are the two factors, but we can break it also. This is x cube plus v cube. So why not we will break it also. This is x plus y, x square minus xy plus y square. And in second bracket, as it is, we will come because already it is solved. So these are the three factors of this expression. Now last question of this exercise, that is question number 13th. Second, our question was x to the power 6 minus 7x cube minus 8. See children, we can solve it by middle term splitting method. Directly I can solve it, but if I will solve it directly, maybe you will feel confused. So instead of using directly, we can do one thing. Okay, minus 8 x cube square minus 7x cube minus 8. Okay, I will solve it in easy way, but I want to explain that method also without taking it as any other variable. You just think this is the first term, this is the middle term, and this is last term. So multiple of this and this number, you middle term, you follow that rule, that midterm splitting method. Split 7 in that way so that their split minus 7 in that way that their product must be equals to minus 8 and their sum or difference equals to minus 7. What I'm telling you, I hope it is clear. No need to convert and take x cube as a, b, c, d. Directly you may start the sum. So what I will do here, let x cube is equals to a. I have changed this number as a. So our equation will be a squared minus 7a minus 8. Now I hope you may easily split this term. So a square, multiple of coefficient of a square is 1, and here is constant term minus 8. So we will multiply it. This is equals to minus 8, and we have to split minus 7 into two terms. So I will take minus 8 and 1, because minus 8 plus 1 is minus 7, and minus 8 into 1 is minus 8. So both are verified. So I have chosen the correct number. So I will write minus 8 a plus a minus 8. So from first two terms, here we are solving by that method of midterm splitting method. From first two terms, I can take a as common, then here is a minus 8, and here is nothing common, so I will take 1 as common. So here is a minus 8. Now from both the places I can take a minus 8 as common, and inside the bracket there is a plus 1. These are common, so a plus 1 is here. What I was telling you, instead of writing a square, you can directly write this value. So here will be x cube minus 7x cube, x cube square minus 7x square, 7x cube plus 7x cube minus 8, and then you will reach to your line. But you may follow this method also, no problem. So now we will put the value, putting the value of a, which is equals to x cube. So our equation will be x cube minus 8 into x cube plus 1. Now we have to use formula of a cube minus b cube. So instead of writing x cube, we will write x cube minus 2 cube, and here x cube plus 1 cube. So here we will use a cube minus b cube formula, and here a cube plus b cube. So for this, what I am going to write, we will write a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square, bracket close. For this, what I will do, again a plus b within bracket a square minus ab plus b square. Okay, sorry, it's not b square, it is 1 square. Okay, now first is x minus 2, first factor is x minus 2, second factor is x square, then 2x plus 4, third factor is x plus b, it is 1, not b. There also I was written 1, this was 1, x plus 1 into x square minus x plus 1. So we are having our answer. So these are the four factors, 1, 2, 3, 4 of this algebraic expression. So thank you for watching my videos, children, and if you are not getting any video, then please search my personal channel, that is Let's Learn with RK. There you will get all the videos. Okay, children, bye bye.